Hello, Kusto community. My name is Ryan Majitimer, product manager on the Azure SAMS Analytics team. I'm joined by Gabi Lehner, who's a principal program manager on the Azure Data Explorer team. He's going to be telling us how you can build dashboards in Azure Data Explorer. Gabi is going to be walking us through the different components of the built-in dashboards for ADX, including when you might use it and what features are available. Gabi, welcome.
Hi, everyone. Today, I'll be talking about Azure Data Explorer dashboards. Azure Data Explorer dashboard is part of Azure Data Explorer web UI, which you can see here. It has a few components. We can start with the home page, where you can do a few things. You can see recommended tutorials. You can get started. And you can see also the documentation. You have the data tab, where you can do all kinds of data ingestion into your tables. You have the query area where you can run queries, and you also have the dashboards, which I will get to in a second. So let's start with a query. You can use the query tab in order to create your own query. You can execute it, and you can also render a visual on top of the results that you're getting. And later on, if you want to use the same data, you can pin it into a dashboard. So you go into the share module. You select the pin to dashboard. You need to give your query or your tile a name. So here I will use the name popularity, because here we have some kind of an index, popularity index, for GitHub events that are being ingested into this table. The data source name is GitHub. You will use the existing data source, which is the database I'm connected to here, for the dashboard, and I will add it into an existing dashboard. The name of the dashboard is GitHub, naturally, because it has event data from GitHub. And as soon as I add the tile, I want to view the dashboard and see the tile there already. I can pin the tile, and as you can see here, the tile was added at the bottom of my dashboard. So here I have a dashboard I created. And all of this dashboard is connected to the same data source, the same GitHub database that contains public event data from GitHub. So you can see that this dashboard contained all kinds of data points, like number of repositories, number of events. It has the type distribution between different event types. I can see here the top 10 popular repositories, number of events over time, and general information about events with some logic defined as conditional formatting on the table itself. Now I'll go into some of the building blocks of dashboards. So to do that, I'll go into editing mode, and I'll start by going into a specific tile. So here, for example, you go into the edit tile mode of this tile, this pie chart. And you can see that underneath it uses a KQL query that runs and retrieves a result, that the result of the query. And then I can transform it into a visual. I can select one of the visual from the visual types I have here. So you see that we have all of the basic visual types. We have tables, bar charts, column charts, area charts, pie charts, like everything that you see here, anomaly chart, maps, and so on and so forth. For each visual, you can configure later on all kinds of visual formatting options. For example, from which columns in the result set it's going to take the data. So here it's quite simple because I have only two columns, but in other cases, you can have dozens of columns. So here you can select from where you're taking the data for your visual. You can define logic related to the legend, to the labels of the pie chart, tooltips, ordering of the pie chart. Do we want to do the ordering by name, by size, or just random ordering according to the order of the query, and so on and so forth. In addition, we have the interaction tab over here. Here we can define cross filters and drill throughs. I'll go into those in a second. I'll show them how they work. Okay, next component I want to show is parameters. Parameters are a very significant key component in dashboards. Parameters are basically a way for us to use specific like lists of values as filters for other tiles and for other filters. So for example, I want to create a parameter that can allow me to filter the data by the event type. And I want to pull the event types from the data itself. I don't want to define it statically. So I need to define the name of the parameter. I need to define the type of the parameter. So here, for example, I'm using a multi-selection parameter. You can see here other types of parameters that we have. For example, single selection, free text in case the user wants to type in the value of the parameter. We have time range and we have data source parameters. So I've selected multiple selection. I need to define the variable name that I'll be using in the queries. There is also a data type that I need to define for these specific parameters on which dashboard pages I want to show it. So I'm going to show these parameters on all parameter called event type on all pages. Here I need to define whether I want to use fixed values or query. So as I said before, I'm going to use a query. I'm using a data source, I'll be using a data source I defined earlier, which is called demo 11. And here you can see I can edit the query. I created here a very simple query that retrieves all of the distinct types of events from the table itself, the event table. So here you see the results. And these are the results that will be later on presented in the parameter in the dashboard itself, and I'll show it in a second. I have here a sample of the results, and then I can define the value column that I'm going to use and the label column in case it's different. And I can use a select all control in order to allow me select all of the values or just a subset of the values. And I can also define a default value. Okay, so here you can see how this parameter is used in a dashboard. It is presented as a filter, as a pill, which allows me to select either all values or just select a few of them. Now you see that once I select a few of them, you see that all of the tiles are filtered accordingly by my selection here. And if I use other parameters, for example, time range, I want to see only the last, 7 days, then again, it's going to filter the data. So these are my components that I use in order to filter the data. I can also use cross filter, which I showed you before. I can go, for example, and select a data point in the pie chart and use it in order to populate the value that I've selected, the value of the data point in the parameter and filter the results accordingly. Then I can remove the selection that I made and the parameter is reset to its previous value. I can also use a drag and drop kind of cross filtering. I can select values here, and then you see that the values are being populated in the time range parameter. And again, all of the tiles that are linked to this parameter are filtered accordingly. Now, let me show you how this linking works on the hood. So I'll go again into the tile that I've showed you before. I showed you the parameter called event type, and that's the value, that's the parameter or the variable name that I'm using in the query. In order to make sure that the parameter is actually affecting this query, I need to embed it as part of the query as a where statement. For example, if I want to use it for filtering, if I want to do something different with it, for example, if I want to summarize by this parameter, I need to embed it in a summarize statement. It depends very much on what I want to do with the parameter. It's like any other like variable that you want to use in the query. So here I used it as a filter, and once I use it in the query, the parameter is enabled and can be used here as well. Okay, so I can use it here again, and you see that it's filtering the pie chart. And if, for example, I highlight this statement, then you see that the parameter is then disabled and I cannot use it anymore. So that's our way to embed the parameters into the queries themselves. Okay. You can share the dashboards with other people in manage permissions. So here you have a way to share the dashboard. In order to share the dashboard, you need to add the user here. So for example, I can add a user, I can add myself. And then once I edit, I will have permissions to this dashboard. Or if I add, I'll add another user, I will have permissions to this dashboard. I also need to make sure that I provide the user with permissions to the underlying data source, the data source that is feeding basically all of the tiles. As you can see, the data source is defined here. So I have two data sources defined for this dashboard. And basically the data source is mainly the URL of the cluster and a specific database in that cluster. This is all for dashboards in a nutshell. We can and we will probably do additional sessions for more deep down dive into specific areas of dashboards. Thank you very much.
Well, that wraps up our video for today. Tell us in the comments, have you used the ADX dashboards? What are your use cases? We'd love to hear about it. Again, my name is Ryan Majitimer. You can find me on Twitter. You can find Azure Data Explorer on Twitter, AZ Data Explorer. Like, comment, subscribe. Thanks for watching. We'll catch you on the next one.